So this is what New Horizons just did, is we flew, it sounds like science fiction, but it's not. We flew all the way across our solar system at the highest speed of any spacecraft ever to encounter the farthest worlds that humans have ever explored. And this is the little planet that we explored. This is Pluto. This is the spacecraft that we built. This is a picture of New Horizons. It's one of my favorites, just about 6 weeks before we launched. We wanted this flyby to be as state-of-the-art as it possibly could. For example, we collected 5,000 times as much data as the first mission to Mars. We took the record for fastest spacecraft ever launched. Let me show you how fast. When I was a kid, Apollo missions were launching to the moon. And they go 25,000 miles an hour and reach the moon in 3 days. New Horizons crossed the orbit of the moon in 9 hours, which is about 0.3 days. We wanted to fly through the shadows of Pluto and Charon, not because it's cool, but because we wanted to watch the sun rise and set through Pluto's atmosphere as a way of very sensitively determining the composition of the atmosphere. And that required us to fly through a box off the side of Pluto that was 100 kilometers tall and 60 kilometers wide, which sounds pretty big, except you're aiming from 3 billion miles away. And so somebody on the project did the math, and I checked it, and it's the equivalent of hitting a golf ball in LA all the way to New York and landing in a soup can. So that's how accurate we had to be in our aim. This is Charon. This big crack that runs for 1,500 kilometers, or almost 1,000 miles. It's much larger than the Grand Canyon. It's much deeper and wider than the Grand Canyon. In fact, it's like Valles Marineris, the biggest canyon in the solar system, which is on Mars. But Charon's not the star of the show. Pluto is. This is Pluto as it really looks, as it would look to your eye. It's about the size of North America. We named the heart, and actually the names that we use, we made up on our team. We love them. We haven't submitted them to become official in a registry. We will, but for now, we're just working with the data, and we need to name things. So the heart is named Tombaugh Regio, after Clyde Tombaugh, who discovered Pluto. This is a movie I wanted to show you, flying over Sputnik Planet as if you were at low altitude. It's our highest resolution stuff, and I just think it's pretty, and you get a chance to see what the geology looks like up close. Here you're going to go on the shoreline of the Aladrissi Mountains, and those are big mountains. They're 10,000 feet tall, and some of them are tens of miles long. And here's some badlands to the northwest of that mountain range, and then out on near polar terrains, where you can see those tracks that may have been created by dust devils. You can see layering in the surface where we have craters, which act as windows into the interior. That's what it would look like to fly over Pluto. This is a picture of Pluto that we made right after the flyby, looking back with the sunlight streaming through Pluto's atmosphere and its true color. It's my favorite image from the whole flyby, and I'll tell you why. When Apollo astronauts went to the moon, they returned film of the Earth rising over the limb of the moon that proved they were there. It's a very visceral image that humans had been to the moon. I worked on this since 1989, and many of my colleagues on the project worked on it a long time too. You could only get a picture like this from the far side of Pluto. It proves we were there. So I wanted to share it with you because it really means a lot to us. And we're super proud to have explored Pluto.